Jess, welcome and thank you for being with me here today.
Thank you, Pina. Thanks for having me.
Jess, how has focusing on a younger client base future-proofed your business?
Yeah, so because we work with 25 to 45-year-olds, their lives are very busy and very full. And so that means that as they continue to grow and their life stages change, our business will continue to evolve and pivot with them. So as they start families, as they start businesses, as they start thinking about schooling their children, we really want to make sure that we continue to deliver them a coaching program that helps them achieve their goals.
Just given AIA Australia specialises in risk, in life insurance. I'm really interested to understand how you talk about the value of life insurance, particularly with a younger client base.
Yeah, so this is something that's very close to my heart, and having worked in the life insurance world for over a decade, I'm incredibly passionate about this. So first and foremost, our clients, of course, are never going to have anything go wrong to them in their whole entire lives. You know, and we have to really overcome those barriers around getting clients to understand that there are risks and there are, you know, things that could happen along the way that are going to mean that those goals that we're working really hard to help them achieve may be completely decimated if due to illness or injury. So for us, it's about making sure that clients really understand that we have a plan A, and that's the ultimate plan that we really want to help them achieve. But we need to also have a plan B. And for me, I kind of bring in my personal story. So my father had a brain tumor and passed away when he was 28 and left my mum and me under 1 year with no life insurance. And so I can give a pretty good response to my younger clients who tell me it's not going to happen to them.
Well, thank you for sharing such a personal story. How do you bring out with a client if something happened to them, if they were to pass away, you know, what would you do? Do you really sort of bring it home to them and present it in a stark reality, or you know, just talk us through how you do that?
So I think firstly there's a bit of debunking that needs to happen. So there's a lot of complexity around all the different insurance products. Do I need this if I have health insurance? Do I have something like this inside my superannuation? So the first part of what we do is really educate clients on what is out there and why they're different, because you can't just have one and then assume that your entire needs are taken care of. So the first part is really around educating them on what is out there and why that's important. And then, yeah, we do a whole heap of whiteboarding. So what I ask them is, tell me all the things that could go wrong. And then let's talk about what impact that would have and what we would need to do to cover you from that issue. And so by the end of that session, actually what happens is we have a whole whiteboard of very morbid things that could happen to someone, but we as a team have had a really great conversation around what is it that we're trying to cover there.
What are your plans to scale the business into the future?
Yeah, this is so exciting for me. And I know that there's so much going on at the moment that it can be really hard to see the opportunity that sits in front of us. But I see tremendous opportunity for our industry. I see tremendous opportunity for advisors in the future. And I think we have to really understand who are the people that we're trying to serve. How is it that they want to work with us, and do our models reflect that? So for me, at the moment, we have a very traditional advice model in that it's bespoke, it's one-to-one, but I'm also really conscious that there are some people who are never going to engage in advice that way. So for me, it's about scaling the business to have different advice models to suit different types of consumers and helping them, whether it's a DIY model, whether it's do part of it for me, or whether it's help me do it all like what we have at the moment. I think that's a tremendous opportunity, and I'd like to think that over the years Fox & Hare will scale to be able to service all of those markets.
So elaborate on that a little bit more in terms of how you plan to cater to those different segments.
Yeah, so I think there's a really important part here around profitability, efficiency and technology. So to deliver advice today, it's expensive, and the margins are definitely being squeezed. So you have to, well, what we have really thought about is how can we deliver online modules that are for people who aren't perhaps ready to engage in a one-on-one context or will never engage in a one-on-one context. That means that it's highly scalable, highly efficient, and utilizing all of the tech that exists out there today. We don't have to build any tech, it already exists.
So as your business grows, so project yourself 10 years forward.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How do you think your business model will change?
I think we will have a bigger team because having only started a little while ago, there's a lot to do in terms of what Glenn and I do every day. You know, just all of the complexity of running a business and delivering advice. I'd like to think that our team will definitely be bigger so that we can make sure that we're getting the right people for the right roles. I think that we won't be a household name. That's not really what we're aiming to be. I do think, however, we'll have fantastic, deep relationships with a number of people and we'll have really been on their journey with them for a long period of time. But I do see this huge opportunity around tech and I just can't let it go. I don't know exactly what we're going to do with it, but I just think, goodness, there's such a lot of opportunity that exists here. There's such a lot of people that feel so overwhelmed and uninspired and lack confidence around money. How can we help them along their journey? And I just think that there's a really great opportunity to bring in the do-it-yourself model, but also the coaching model. Is there a way to coach people through, you know, artificial intelligence, through predictive analysis? You know, what does that look like? And because I'm a small business, that shouldn't prohibit me from thinking about pivoting my business accordingly.
Thank you, Jess. Thank you for sharing so much about your business and about yourself. It's been an absolute delight. Thank you.
Thanks, Pina. Thank you for having me.